Hello.
Hello.
What's your name?
Morgane Jourdain.
Hey Morgan, I'm here to do an assignment for my college, and I would like to have a few questions. If you have time, I would be very pleased to answer and give me some information about some questions. Are you? Do you have time?
Yes, of course.
Okay, thank you. And how old are you?
I'm 25.
Okay, and what do you study now?
I'm studying linguistics.
Okay, nice. Where do you study?
I study in KU
Okay. Where did you do your bachelor?
I did my bachelor in my home country in France, in the University of Lille.
Okay, nice. And did you study abroad with the program?
Yes, I studied in the UK.
Okay, and how long do you study there?
I studied at the University of York for 1 year.
So you said you studied at the University of York.
York.
Where does it located exactly?
It is located in the north of England, not so far from Scotland.
Okay, nice. And why did you choose UK?
I didn't really choose the country. I heard about the university because, so during my bachelor, I was studying languages, so I was doing English and Japanese. And I heard about the University of York because they had an excellent linguistics program, and I wanted to do a master in linguistics. So I didn't really choose the country, I chose the university.
Okay, nice. And what's the different what's the difference between studying at your where you study your bachelor and studying in UK?
Well, there is a huge difference in the way university classes are taught in France and in the UK. Is that in France you have much more contact hours and really less work at home, whereas in the UK I really had like 6 hours per week, whereas in France it was like at least 20, 25, and the work were mostly done on our own. That was the biggest, I would say, difference. We also had bigger projects, so in France studying involved mostly exams, so you just learn, you make the exam. Whereas their system was much more about making us do very big assignments, group assignments, bigger projects. Yeah.
Okay, and how did you find the people and the culture there in UK, and difference between the culture and the people you are?
Yeah, it's always difficult for French people in the UK.
Okay.
So they were not so bad. The thing is, I feel like they're a bit cold people. So they were a bit difficult to become friends with. They don't show emotion so much. So when you're talking to them, you don't know if they are bored with you or not, or if they are happy to be with you or not. And that was just yeah, a bit weird. So in the end, I just found it extremely easier to become friends with the other exchange students. So we were having parties just with the other Erasmus students, basically, and not so much with the locals. And I was not the only one in that case. I really found out that a lot of exchange students who go to the UK are friends with a lot of foreign people, but not so much with British people. It's not that they're mean or rude or anything, it's just they are hard. It's really hard to really break the ice with them.
I see. Okay, now coming to the economical point of the US trip, and asking you that, how was the living cost there?
The living cost in the UK is definitely much higher than in France, especially as a student, because in France, so everything like linked to the university is partly paid by the French government. So for example, we didn't have to pay for like syllabus. So you know when you have like these big booklets of printed papers that the teachers ask you to buy. Well, in France they don't ask you to buy anything, just give them to you. School meals, university meals are like the price in France is 3 euros and 10 cents, and that's like a general country thing. so they can't raise higher. It's like this big company that deals with the food throughout the country. So yeah, for €3.10, you had like the full meal with three side dishes.
Mm-hmm.
So that's really cheap. By contrast, in the UK, I remember that for £3, you had almost nothing. And yeah, it was... Yeah, and even the food was not so great. So I really don't understand why it was so expensive.
Mm-hmm.
And the food, the supermarket was much more expensive. I also went at the time where the conversion between the euros and the pounds were not so great.
Mm-hmm.
So books, university, we had to buy university books. In France, university teachers are required to make a syllabus so students don't have to buy books, which are very expensive.
Mm-hmm.
So these are all things that French universities really think about to make life cheaper for students. So it was a bit difficult.
Okay. And even for the Sunday nights, if you go to out, and how was the expenses and the costs?
Yeah, when I was back in France, I was not partying so much, so I can't really say how expensive it is for France. Actually, clubs were not expensive. I mean, I remember that in New York, I went clubbing a couple of times, and I really don't remember paying more than £5. And sometimes, it was very easy to just do something on Facebook. A lot of clubs had like games, and it was very easy to just get free entrances all the time. And when you were a girl, if you were in some of them, if you were going before midnight, it was free or something.
Okay.
That was actually quite cheap. The beers were cheap, but they were not good. The problem. Yeah, they have crappy drinks, so that's really good. They were not too expensive.
Okay.
Yeah.
And how was the life condition there in UK?
Well, I mean, the student rooms were not so great. But when I was back in France, I was living at my parents', so I can't really know. I can't really compare between my home country and the UK about that, but I would say it was fine, mostly because the Erasmus program provided me with a scholarship, so it was actually quite fine. I would say that the like dorm facilities were really not so great. They were very old. We were too many people for two. Like I had to share my bathroom with a lot of people who like ate or something. Sometimes in the morning, it was a bit annoying.
I see.
Yeah.
So let's come to the general questions asking you that: how was the overall experience studying abroad?
It was extremely positive because I would say. The campus life in the UK is a really amazing experience. It helped me get out of my shell and just experience socializing and meeting so many other Erasmus students was like the most amazing experience of my life. I really started going out and I have to say that I became less serious with my studies, so it's very risky. But I think it was really one of the best years of my life.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you definitely recommend the students to go study abroad.
Yes, of course. You have to be careful if you're not a very serious student from the beginning, though, because you can very easily just end up partying all the time with other Erasmus students and making so many friends and go out and everything. But if you are still able to control yourself and do your studies, I mean, this is really, really great. And because, you know, there are all these people you know you're only going to spend 1 year with, you just want to go crazy and just to really live the life at the fullest because you know you're not going to see them anymore afterwards.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, it gives a special spice to life. It was really great.
Okay, and once again... what would be your advice for the students who intend to do the Erasmus in UK?
I would say to be careful with your studies. First of all, as I said, I was lucky because I was very, very serious from the beginning, so even though I loosened up, I didn't go too overboard and just stop studying altogether. So be careful with that. But I would say that don't be afraid to talk to people. So even if you are shy from the beginning, you are just going to meet all people who don't know you. So just, yeah, just try to live the life at the fullest, and be careful with the money, especially if you go to a country which doesn't use the same currency as you, because sometimes you can make mistakes in your budget. Because sometimes, like especially with me, like it was in the UK with the pound, so things could seem cheaper than what they actually were. So yeah, £35 for a week of groceries were actually quite a lot, but for me it was much more than €35, and yeah, so I should have been more careful. A couple of times I had to call my parents for rescue once or twice, yes. But yes, maybe try to save money before, because so they have scholarships for students, but I know that in the Erasmus program, so we all the money, we had it the first half in December and the second half at the end. So it was mostly used to like recover from all the costs, but you didn't have them really before. So I would say maybe if you don't have a lot of money first, just do a student job during the summer before you go, just to ensure that you have enough savings from the beginning. Okay. I would say also try to really maybe look for the administration system of the university before you go, because I mean administration and university are always very complicated matters. I mean, and when it's in a foreign country, it can be extremely confusing, and some countries may have harder rules than your country, and you might have real big problems because you are too used to a maybe looser system, like I was in France. So yes, be careful about that. Choose your university carefully. Really look for the university program, because it would be too bad to go abroad and just go to a university whose program is not as interesting as the one from your home university. So just really try to pick something that really has something you would not be able to do otherwise.
Okay, thank you, and thanks for the time you have given. Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Thank you.